Hey guys, so today it is Monday, October 12th, 2020, and so Monday night dinner, so doing Vietnamese, and I ordered some spring rolls, and then I ordered this weird dish. It's this vermicelli, and what the heck sauce is this? I don't know why I ordered this, because I know I don't like fish sauce, and they always give fish sauce, and so, yeah. And so, yeah, so, alright, you guys. Just something different. Hey, guys, so, happy Monday. So, today it is Monday, October 12, 2020. It is just past 8:30 p.m. So, today it is the Canadian Thanksgiving, but it's like, this year I am not really feeling festive at all, and so it's like I usually go to some family for Thanksgiving, but then it's like with the way the world situation, and then with the way my dad's passing away, and so like nobody is like in the mood to do anything this year, and so yeah, and also because some of my cousins have kids, right? And so they go to school. Oh my gosh, it's like all fish sauce. I don't like it. Ugh. I'm not gonna be using the fish sauce. Like, I don't know, it's like, am I not Asian enough? Like, I just don't like fish sauce. It's like, so I ordered some chicken spring rolls. And, yeah. Usually, like, because I rent, right? So it's not very convenient to host the party. And so usually I go to some of my cousins for the holidays or whatnot. But this year, nothing is happening. And so, over the weekend, I realized I made an achievement over the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. This, again, it tastes similar to the Filipino spring rolls. It's got a lot of carrots and chicken. On Saturday and Sunday, I hang out with people. I hang out with two people, few different people for lunch. And so one of the things that I do not understand about Vietnamese food, it's like, basically, it's like a bunch of stuff thrown on top of rice or noodles. Like, I don't get it, but oh my god. Ugh. I cannot believe they did not give any soy sauce or oyster sauce. And so, I've never really understood the Vietnamese food, so sorry if Vietnamese is your culture and I'm kind of, like, not really knowing about your culture, but it always seems like a weird cross between Chinese food and something else. Like, normally with Vietnamese food, I order the soup, but I just wanted to try something different. And these are some Vietnamese meatballs. And I was thinking about Vietnamese subs, but I just did not feel like bread. I cannot believe they did not give any hoisin sauce or anything. So yeah. So what I mean by Saturday and Sunday was sort of an achievement was because when I go out to eat, I usually eat out on my own and I usually never ask anybody to eat out with me. And so, and I just plop on some music and off I go. And on Saturday, I hang out with this one cousin that I don't think I've ever hang out with before. And then we went to Korean food, and I was wanting to do bulgogi and stuff like that, the Korean barbecue, but then I saw on the menu they have those Korean hot pot things that you see on YouTube everywhere. And then they had the army base stew, and I've heard about it for like forever, but I've like never tried it before. And so, like, we were two people. And then we also ordered a japchae because I love japchae. And then the army base stew is like, we can barely finish it for two people. And then there was like two tall containers to take out containers, and it was all the leftovers. Then so I had it for leftovers for lunch today. It was so much food, you guys. Like it could have been enough for two. The leftovers that could have been enough for two meals. It took me like over an hour to eat it. And then on Sunday, I went out with a friend to dim sum with she and her boyfriend. And so we went to this Chinese restaurant that I never been to before. And I don't know why, like, over the years, my family never goes to it, and it's been in like Chinatown for like forever. Maybe I should have gone with the Vietnamese Yeah, it's like this year for 2020, it's like so messed up. It's like With the Thanksgiving now, and then the holidays are coming, it's like totally doesn't feel festive at all. It's like the last person that died in my family was like one of my uncles. But maybe though it's like because my uncle is not like a direct family, right? So it's not like I have a direct relationship with my uncle or something like that. So when he died, it's like it did not really affect me as much. So, yeah. And so on Saturday, I did do an online grocery haul, but I did buy a roast beef. So I'm probably gonna be cooking it tomorrow. I don't know, but like I felt like a roast beef, and then so I just ordered it. I haven't done a roast beef in ages. And so thinking about it, like the roast beef cost like 30 something bucks for the one piece of meat, the roast. And then I bought potatoes and celery and carrots and onion, and then that cost an additional $6 or so. And then so it's like less than 40 bucks. So making a roast beef meal for less than 40 bucks is actually not too bad. And it's like a few days of meals for me. And so the grocery store that I'm online shopping with, they do these sort of points things. And so I've done it 7 or 8 times and I sort of collected a lot of points now. And so apparently I was able to redeem a free loaf of bread, a free pack of paper towels, a free pack of orange. And then I got a free cake out of it. So I got 4 free items from this shopping. But then I forgot now it's almost the winter time now, and it's like I totally forgot about it, and it's like the oranges, they were pretty sucky. It's like it is not orange season anymore. And then I bought some apples, and lately I've been into ambrosia apples. I like that. My dad's funeral is on Thursday. And so have to get ready for that. And so I am so surprised because one of my aunts, like my mom's older sister, like I rarely talk with her. And then so because lately my mom and my brother has been like assholes, like ever since my dad died. And then I had a nice long conversation with my aunt and about the way my mom and my brother has been treating me like assholes and stuff like that. And so my aunt said, on Thursday, like she is gonna make sure that my mom behaves and that she doesn't treat me like an asshole on Thursday. So I am not sure how that is gonna work, but we will see. And then also I told my aunt the real story about how I've been treated, and it's like after since me and my ex divorced and how my parents they treated me crappy and they treated me like shit. Like none of my family knows the full story. And so, like, I could feel it in the phone conversation that I could feel it in the phone conversation that my aunt's like jaws like dropped. So yeah. That was one horrible sneezing spell. So, I had a viewer that commented on my eyebrows that my eyebrows look pretty thick or something, that I should wax my eyebrows or something. Does it really look that bad? Like, this meal was okay. It's like eating a salad. It's like a nice and refreshing meal and not overly greasy. I don't know if that meal, though, if it was worth the $13, though. And then for some reason, I wanted to order an appetizer, and so they were selling like five dumplings for like $7. I'm like, no way, Jose. It's like at the Chinese restaurant, you could get it for 10 dumplings for the same price. This Uniqlo shirt, it looks really good on camera, doesn't it, you guys? And so I already checked the app again, and so this shirt for the men's department is already no longer available on the app. So this Uniqlo shirt that I got, nice. I really like it. All right, you guys. So, thank you so much for tuning in today, guys. And don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel. And I will see you in the next one.